Welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. In this episode, we'll make an arbor for this diamond grinding wheel. And we use a homemade rotary table on the drilling machine. We also see how the diamond wheel grinds this carbide braze tool. So let's go into the workshop.
I've just roughed out an arbor for the diamond grinding wheel. This is the diamond grinding wheel. It's on an aluminium backing, and around the edge it's got diamond grit bonded. So on this one, I've just got to turn this diameter down to match that, get the right depth, put a 11mm bore in to match the cutter grinding bore.
I can't use a centre bore to hold the wheel on the arbor.
On the cutter grind, you're going backwards and forwards depending on which side you're using. Clockwise, anti-clockwise. There is a chance that it could unscrew this, make it loose. So what I'm going to do is put three holes in here and bolt it through the flange into the arbor. So the first thing is I've center drilled it, roughed out the shape. Now what I want to do is put drill a hole about 10mm and then bore it out to 11. I'm not sure what this material is. It's very tough. Obviously it's a steel, but it's not a free cutting steel. It looks like a toughened steel. It's something I've had lying around for years and found a use for it. Let's see how it drills. Change the boring bar to this boring bar. I'm getting a lot better finish now. It's not like an old nail. This little bit of bar is exactly the right size. Still needs a bit coming out. It can't be far off. Looking for 11mm. So that boring bar that looks like an old nail gives a far superior finish. This is the fourth axis of my CNC machine, and what I've done is I've clamped it to the drilling machine to see if I can use it to get the spacing for the three holes. You can see at the bottom I've had to take the back off the machine, off the axis, because the plug was at the back of this. To stop the wires getting crushed, I've put it on a 10mm plate to give me a space. And that gives me just enough height to use it on the machine. I've never used it on the drilling machine before, but add a push. This is centred at the moment. I can get this underneath and just centre drill and drill a 4mm hole just about in the three locations. So what I'm going to do now is put a bolt through there. Tighten that up. That's just to stop the washer at the top moving round when I start to drill. So now I've got the arbor and the washer. I want three holes for three cap heads. So put that in the chuck. I've already centered the chuck. So what I'm going to do is swing the table across to give me the offset. Swing the table across. Switching on my fourth axis. The axis now is on zero where I've drilled the first centre drill mark. So I now want to rotate that 120 degrees to the second one. So I've put my cross slide table back on, but mainly to get a bit more stability because it was vibrating too much on the fourth axis. But now I've sharpened the drill up that broke off. That's the finished diamond wheel arbor, and I put this washer on and the hole in the middle so you can extract it by putting a bolt through, and that can extract it from the motor spindle. Otherwise you've got no way of getting it off without taking the front of the guard off, trying to lever it, or you've got nothing to hold on to if you just put the cap head straight into the aluminium. I've just got a tungsten carbide tip tool in there. Let's put some black felt tip on the end so you can see where I'm grinding. It's a diamond wheel. This is my fourth axis that I made. Basically that's the chuck off the lathe. We've got just a box. Just dump all of this. Inside we've got, this is a stepper motor pulley connected to the stepper motor, which is the same as I have on my CNC machine, same motor. This is just a bearing on a tensioner. So you turn the bar there, little tension the belt. That's a pulley attached to the spindle that goes through with the chuck on the other end. The spindle are made exactly the same as the Boxford, except it hasn't got a back gear on. So it's a 20mm bore straight through. Number two Morse taper on the other end, and the same thread as the chuck, so I can put the three jaw, the four jaw chuck, collets, or anything that goes in the lathe will fit in this. It's in there, the 20 collets on the end of that. The drawbar will go through it to pull that in. That's the bearing on this end. I've got the same inside at the back. The other thing I made this, when I made it, it's only made out of MDF as a prototype, but the main idea was, with the chuck offset, I could turn this box round and I've got different positions for that chuck, so I can have it lower or higher on the machine. I haven't tried it in the lathe yet, but that was the idea, so I could move it up or down in the lathe. And also, as you saw on the drilling machine, I can store it up that way. What I think I might do is put another access point for the cable, so I can put the cable in either side. I've also put some slots in, top and bottom. They're just cut in with a biscuit joint cutter, where you can put the clamping strips in to hold the head still. And that's on each side, top, bottom, and the other sides. If you're thinking of making a rotary head, one of the systems you need from a CNC machine to work this, Mark III on the computer, the stepper box, and stepper motor, and some way of turning your chuck. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, why not subscribe? And we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.